The purpose of this film is to show the operational sequence for preventive maintenance on the Alfa Romeo Model 156. Let's now see all the details divided by different operations. The operation includes replacing the idling actuator and reprogramming the engine control unit. Check this area for the presence of the green paint spot on the idling actuator certifying car updating. Replace the actuator if the green paint spot is missing. After neutralizing any anti-theft device, disconnect the battery negative pole. Disconnect the engine control unit connectors with their levers. Detach the oil vapor suction tube from the air intake sleeve with its click pincers. Loosen the suction sleeve clamps and release the accelerator cable from the spring. After loosening the clamp, remove the sleeve by sliding it out from the support bracket. Release the control unit cable from its clamp and disconnect the ground lead. Release the accelerator cable from the butterfly control cam. Remove the four lock screws from the butterfly body and disconnect its electrical wire from the actuator. After positioning the butterfly body on a support, loosen the three idling actuator lock screws and remove the actuator. The new actuator with the green paint spot is supplied with the kit. Check that the window on the new actuator corresponds to the butterfly valve control insert. Position the new seal on the butterfly body. Reassemble the actuator, taking care that matching is effortless. Tighten lock screws to 5 Newton meters. After replacing the seal, reassemble the butterfly body on the suction duct by tightening the lock screws to between 8 and 10 Newton meters. After completing reassembly operations, check engine control unit reprogramming. Use the kit to reprogram. The kit consists of a Bosch adapter, a 9-pin male-to-male adapter, a reprogramming disc, two envelopes containing engine control unit identification labels, and an instructions booklet. Connect the Bosch adapter by inserting it between the control unit and the car cabling. Be careful of connector orientation. Connect the 9-pin adapter to the socket on the rear panel of the SDC and insert the adapter cable. If the SDC has no external socket, remove the panel and connect directly to the computer socket. Turn the key to start and insert the disc into the SDC reader. Switch the SDC on and wait for about 3 minutes for reprogramming, which ends when OK is displayed. Switch the SDC off and remove the disc. Place the switch on stop. Remove the adapter and connect cabling to the engine control unit. Turn the key to start and wait for 30 seconds. Place the key on stop and wait for at least 30 seconds before completing other operations. After reprogramming is complete, check proper engine idling with or without load. Lastly, replace the engine control unit identification label to certify the operation, selecting it according to engine type. Use the kit to proceed with reprogramming. The kit consists of a Bosch adapter, a reprogramming disc, two envelopes containing engine control unit identification labels, and an instructions booklet. Connect the Bosch adapter by inserting it between the control unit and the car cabling. Be careful of connector orientation. Insert the adapter cable into the examiner socket placed on the right-hand side. Only supply the equipment with the car battery. Place the start key on start, insert the reprogramming disc, and switch the examiner on. Wait for about 3 minutes and remove the disc after OK is displayed. Switch the examiner off. Place the key on stop and disconnect cables. Remove the adapter and reconnect car cabling. Place the key on start and wait for 30 seconds. Place the key on stop and wait for at least 30 seconds before performing any other operation. After reprogramming, check proper operation of the engine at idling with and without load. Lastly, replace the engine control unit identification label to certify the operation, selecting it according to engine type. The operation requires replacing the ABS sensors. Lift the car and check whether the four ABS sensors are updated. Updating is indicated by the orange spot on the sensor and the date impressed. Updated sensors must carry the year 98 and the week number indicated by the notch must be over 5. Modification, in fact, started from the fifth week of 1998. Also, the protection cover of new sensors does not adhere to the cable to allow seeped water drainage. Replace all non-updated sensors with the new ones supplied in the kit. Slide out the connector from the front wheels. Loosen the cable and loosen the sensor lock screw. Reinstall the new sensor following the above directions in the reverse order. Slide out the connector from the rear wheels too. Loosen the cable and loosen the sensor lock screw. Reinstall the new sensor following the above directions in the reverse order. The operation requires replacing the fuel filter bypass valve. Remove the south deadening cover on the cylinder head. Check the valve for the presence of the green paint spot, certifying updating. Otherwise, disconnect the valve. Install the new valve with the green spot and the new seals. Tighten the valve to between 30 and 35 newton meters. Check that no errors are present on the engine control unit with the diagnosis equipment. Reinstall the sound deadening cover. The operation requires replacing the alloy wheel attachment bolts. Alloy wheel attachment bolts with chrome-plated surface protection can be recognized by their bright white color and must be replaced with dull gray color ones. Twenty bolts per car are required. Tighten to between 7.8 and 9.5 newton meters. This operation can be completed without lifting the car and replacing the various bolts one at a time. The operation requires partial or total replacement of tubes and the hydraulic drive heat exchanger. Operations are diversified by model and each has a specific kit. The operation involves checking and replacing tubes A, B, and C if necessary. Check the heat exchanger. In the presence of cylindrical spirals, the car is updated. In the absence of the spiral, or the presence of a conical spiral, the car requires updating. Remove the battery holder, and the protection below the engine. Suck out oil from the hydraulic drive reservoir with a syringe. Remove clamps and disconnect tubes between the heat exchanger and the rigid piping. Lift the car and remove tubing. For cars without a spiral exchanger, insert the two spring stud bolts supplied with the kit. Install the square supplied with the kit and attach it with nuts. Bench assemble the two rubber pads and the support brackets to the new exchanger. Install the completed exchanger by attaching it to the square already present on the bodywork. slide the rubber tubes over the rigid piping, and secure with new clamps. With the special tooling, disconnect tube C between the hydraulic drive and the rigid pipe. Replace it with the updated one supplied with the kit. The operation involves replacing tube D between the tank and the piping, connecting with the heat exchanger. Remove and replace tube D with the updated one supplied with the kit using adequate tooling. The operation involves replacing tube E between the pump and the hydraulic drive. Remove and replace tube E with the updated one supplied with the kit using adequate tooling. The operation involves replacing tube F between the tank and the hydraulic drive pump. Remove and replace tube F with the updated one supplied with the kit using adequate tooling. The operation requires checking proper assembly of the steering column joint. Check for the presence of the white paint spot on the joint. Or the presence of the plastic safety ring visible in the steering column cut. The car is updated in both cases. Otherwise, remove the screw and position the joint correctly. Install the new screw and washer at the hydraulic drive pinion throat and tighten to between 1.9 and 2.1 newton meters. Do not detach the joint from the pinion to prevent improper positioning of the steering wheel at subsequent wheel alignment check. Place a white paint spot on the joint at the cut. The operation requires inserting a noise-deadening bushing on the guide rack. The wheel is removed for film shooting needs, but this operation is not required in the operating cycle. Rotate the steering wheel clockwise to turn end. Check for the presence of a yellow paint spot on the area, certifying the modification is already incorporated. Otherwise, remove the clamp from the bellows. Push the bellows until the cap, the cup with the strike deadener, and the end part of the rack are free. Check for the presence of a throat on the rack end. If there is none, the guide does not require updating. Use the kit if the throat is present. Partially open the bushing and insert it onto the rack rod. Orient the cut towards the operator. Slide the elastic ring on the bushing and orient the open part on the part opposite the bushing cut. Reposition the bellows using the new clamp. Put two yellow paint spots on the tie rod to certify operation completion. The operation requires inserting a heat protection sheath on the tube from the pump to the hydraulic drive. With the car placed on the auto lift, check for the presence of the white color heat protection sheath on the tube. Otherwise, remove the protection under the engine and the exhaust pipe clamp. Lower the front end of the exhaust pipe and remove the rear end. After removing the plastic bracket, cut and remove 120 millimeters of rubber protection sheath. Slide the heat protection sheath over the pipe and attach it with a clamp on the corrugated part of the pipe. The upper end of the sheath and the rubber protection must match and not cover one another. Reinstall the components removed previously using new washers for the exhaust pipe. The operation requires replacing the oil heat exchanger coolant liquid tube. Operating from the engine compartment, check for the presence of the white paint spot on the area, certifying update. Otherwise, replace the tube. With the car on the auto lift, remove the protection under the engine. Arrange for a container to collect coolant liquid. With the pincers, loosen the three clamps above and below. Slide the tubes out. Remove the support square lock screw. Loosen the nut and remove the rigid tube. Install the new tube and clamps by proceeding in the opposite order as for removal. Restore proper liquid level in the expansion reservoir and reinstall the protection under the engine. Certify operation completion with a white paint spot on the connection. The operation requires replacing the engine coolant electrical fan resistor. Check the area for the presence of the white paint spot, certifying update. Otherwise, replace the resistor. Disconnect the battery. Disconnect connections. And remove the resistor. On the 1.9 JTD, 2.4 JTD, 2.5 V6 condition versions, repeat the operation for the second resistor. Install the resistors suitable for the model according to the table. Restore connections. After operation completion, apply a white paint spot to the resistor base. For all operations, we recommend following the procedures described in the operation cycles and service publications very carefully.